Swagged out, familiar, we bringing them cats out. I still got some racks stuffed in the trap house. Off the 42, I'm blowing her back out. I'm back on my bullshit, been back with a full clip. They say I...
Welcome back to my channel. This is another Am I the Asshole? I got a couple more stories for y'all. And then, I always forget to put this at the beginning of the video, but let me know what y'all think in the comments, okay? We're not gonna argue because, you know, I said what I said. But if y'all have a different perspective, I would like to hear it, as long as y'all respectful, okay? Put it in the comments, okay? Anyway, Am I the Asshole for removing a woman's charger and charging my laptop? This happened at the airport phone laptop charging station. I was charging my laptop I needed for a meeting very soon, and I sat beside the charging station. I was not actively monitoring my laptop, but I was looking at it randomly. Once when I checked, I saw my computer laptop pulled out for who knows how long and a random woman charging her phone and in a call. I looked at the charger that she had removed without my permission and said nothing. She told me something like, I need to charge my phone, and continued her call. To me, this was kind of understandable. It was definitely rude. These things have etiquette, not the least of which is not touching, removing things without permission. She didn't even say sorry, but like, whatever. She had a call. I nodded that she had did her call. Later, once her call was done, she removed her phone charger and I plugged in my laptop, thinking that this thing was over. And she sneers at me and tells me kind of angrily, I'm charging my phone. Now I'm actually annoyed. She ends the call, and what she says wasn't a thank you for letting me charge my phone or sorry for removing your charger. Can I please charge my phone here for one more time? Or I need to, you know, whatever. This was just her acting like I was a nuisance. So next time she left her phone, leaving her charger behind, I remove it and charge my laptop and sit down. She comes back saying I was charging my phone, this time definitely angrily. I normally would have said something like, I really need to charge, I'm sorry, or even offered to let her charge her phone for some time. I have 35% charging on my laptop in about 1 hour. I can afford to let her charge for like 10 minutes. But I was done with her shit. I just said sorry, not very apologetically, and she starts yelling, you're so disrespectful, I can't believe you're so disrespectful. And I replied, what about when you remove my laptop without permission? She says, I have personal reasons. I can't believe so disrespectful. I didn't think I was too out of line. If she needed a favor, she should have said in a less entitled way or not yelled and sneered. I was definitely not the kindest person here, but I don't think I was the asshole. Was I? You was an asshole enough, okay? Nothing you did was really unkind, but I would have been hella unkind, okay? I don't give a... Y'all, there was this video not too long ago of this lady, but this was like car charging, right? This lady was charging her car at the little charging station, you know, like at the gas station they have like the little charging thing, right? She was charging her car. She goes into the store for a second to get like a drink or something, and then she comes out and this girl had unplugged her car and plugged her car in, and then the girl like was filming the whole situation. I'm gonna put a link to it in the description because y'all need to see this. But the girl was like filming her trying to act like the other lady was the Karen for being upset, and it's like, no, why would you unplug her car? And she was like, I have a son that I need to go pick up, and da da da. That lady was like, I don't give a fuck about your kid. She was like, that's your problem. Because, like, why would you unplug? Like, it's just entitlement, bro. Like, and I bet this lady was older, too. Like, it's just so entitled. Why would you unplug somebody else's device to plug your, like, you could have just asked. And, like, I feel like the car thing was worse. Cause, I don't know. I'm a real calm person. I know y'all not gonna believe me when I do these Am I the Asshole videos. I am a calm person. Like, I like to approach situations reasonably. But y'all, like, people just be so entitled and dumb and rude. And sometimes it just be jumping out of me, okay? I would, girl, I'm gonna put the link to that video. Or I'm gonna put it in the video because y'all need to see, like, she cussed that lady out. Like, the girl had her friend looked like she was trying to fight. And girl, you unplugged my car and now you want to fight? Girl, I will. Anyway, but yeah, you unplugged somebody's car and you trying to film like you was a Karen. And then everybody was eating her ass up on TikTok and she put her page on private and deleted the video. Cause everybody was like, why would you post this? Like, you were in the wrong and you need your ass beat. Like, you lucky that lady didn't swing off on you. Awesome. He's gonna pick up my kid. That lady said, fuck your kid. She said, fuck your 3-year-old. That's so real. But yeah, don't be unplugging people's stuff. Like, that's so rude. Like, you're not more important than somebody because you got a little situation. Just ask. Anyway. Anyway. I think I'm gonna do 5 because I have some really short ones up in here. Oh damn. Well, this one got deleted, so maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm not. Anyway. All right. It's another short one, another family one. Am I the asshole for telling my son that he can't have the neighbors over unless I'm there? My 11-year-old son, Jaden, is a really good and responsible kid, so I definitely give him a long leash. One of the things I allowed him to do is leave him home alone with his friends while I'm out running errands. Yes, the other parents are fine with that because they trust me and my son, and his friends respect me. When my son's friends are over, they probably spent most of their time in his room where there are no security cameras. I could still hear the audio if I wanted, but it would just be kids laughing and screaming. We have next door neighbors who have ten and 12-year-old daughters. I have mixed feelings about them, but they behave when they know they're being watched, so I don't mind if they come over to play video games with my son in the living room. Today I went to get a haircut with my 7-year-old and left my son home alone. I got a ring notification that it was the shorty girls. They asked me if he wanted to play a new video game with them. My son said sure and invited them in. I called my son and said no, they aren't allowed over unless I am there. Of course he asked why. I said we'll talk when I get back. He said they're his friends and I understand, but tell them that I said no one is allowed over right now. He was pretty angry and called me a few names after we hung up. Y'all must be. When I got home, I explained to him that I'm not okay with the girls being alone in the house. He asked why. I said, because of your hormones and judgment are not reasonable enough. He said, Dad, they're my friends, not my girlfriend. I said, let's keep it that way. They can come over if an adult is here. The shorty girl's parents told me that I can't be serious and how I can trust a boy who peed in our bush to be home alone, but with our son, but not their daughters who are good kids. I said, because tween kids have questionable impulse control, and I'd rather have a tween boy pee in my bushes than have home become a tween dad. Girl, I don't think she an asshole, and y'all gonna find out why I don't think she an asshole real soon, because I have a story about my younger cousin that I grew up with, and she was home alone a lot, and she used to have boys over, and she used to do a lot of crazy shit at 10, 11 years old. So this is not, I don't think you're being the asshole at all. You should, because just because people seem like good kids, I was a good kid. Like, I was actually a good kid. I didn't do nothing, but I was like, I was the good kid that was getting left home with the bad kids because I was responsible and I could watch them even though I was like a year or a couple years older than them. So just know, teenagers, like, y'all be thinking, oh, they're only 10, they're only 11. No, they be doing shit, okay? They be doing shit. So you are not wrong for not wanting some little girls at the house with your son, because I'm not saying it's the little girls or it's the little boy, but you never know. Like, if only y'all knew. Like, it was people that my uncle would think, oh, that's a good little boy. He a nice young man. So no, yeah, that's smart. I would say the same thing if it was a daughter. Yeah.
No, ma'am.
And y'all gotta watch. Y'all gotta be careful. Little girls be being fast for other little girls too, I'm just saying. Okay. Not blaming it on the child, but you know, that type of stuff be happening. I seen it. So, you know. All right. Two more, y'all. Two more. These are the last two are family ones. I didn't realize that so many people have issues with their family. Sorry, my titty itch. So many people got issues with their family being assholes, but it is what it is, okay? I'm gonna try to find some more juicy ones about non-family, because I like the little outside Karen stuff, okay? Anyway, am I the asshole? My husband messed up for the third time. Some backstory, my 31, Oh, I think she's trying to say I'm 31 and my husband, 31, have been together for 12 years and married 6. He has never really been good with money, and shortly after we moved in together, he got us in debt by not paying the bills and maxing out his credit cards for, I think that's Euro. No, that's not Euro. What's the other one? Not the Euro, but the one that looked like an L. I forgot. I don't know what the name of it is, but 2,000 of that, okay? All the bills were in his name, and I just sent him money each month, and we split the bills 50-50. Not touching that one, girl. Turned out he wasn't using the money for bills and was using it on dinners out, treating me, and holidays. I found out when a debt letter was sent to the house in his name, and I accidentally opened it. I asked him, and he lied about it and said when I showed him the proof, When I showed him the proof, he confessed and said that he was sorry and his intentions were good. His mom bailed us out, and we got back on track, and I put the bills in my name. So I know they get paid. Then a few years later, after the marriage and our first child, it happened again with his credit cards. And it was about 4,000 of whatever that currency is. Okay. I'll put it on screen. and he's not made any effort to pay it off and tanked his credit, which affected us as we were trying to get a mortgage. We have a massive argument. And he begged and pleaded for another chance for our family and was so sorry and wanted to correct it. We put a plan in place and he paid them off and canceling the card since then, all has been fine. We recently had another baby 9 months ago, and even though I'm on maternity, I still pay 50-50 to bill. Girl. Anyway. Not touching that. We are due to remortgage in April. So I wanted to get a jump on things. And when the paperwork we needed. Oh. I wanted to get a jump on things with what paperwork we still need, making sure that our credit is okay and see if we can save up a little more cash for then. I look at our credit scores and his is worse than before, and it turns out that he got a new credit card and maxed them out all around 5,500 whatever dollars altogether. I confronted him again, and yet again he lied. When I showed him the proof, he was like a deer in headlights. At first, I gave him an ultimatum saying he has by New Year to pay them off and build his credit. Otherwise, I walk. And for now, he can sleep in the spare room as he has broken my trust and I don't want our kids to notice. So he goes to bed after our kids are asleep. A week went by and I tried to put on a brave face for the kids, but today I just broke down. I feel completely and utterly broken. I have no trust left, no emotions. I feel like a shell. I lost it on him and told him how much he has hurt me and is now and how shattered he has made me. I asked him to leave and go to his mother's. He started to cry. He never cries. And afterwards, my little girl started asking where he was. So I did a movie night for us and left her to sleep in my bed. Now I'm sitting here feeling awful, wondering if I'm the asshole by making him leave. I know everyone will tell me to run and he won't change, but I love him and he's an amazing dad. But I also have this voice that keeps saying I'm a doormat and he won't change. I don't know what to do. My friends watch these videos and y'all already know what I'm gonna say, but I'm not gonna get too deep in this. Should not be called am I the asshole. It should be am I fucking stupid. Because why are you with a man? Why are you married? You've been together with this man for 12 years, married for 6. Why would you be with a man that you gotta pay 50-50 bills with? That don't make sense. Like, girl, I don't know what to tell you. Okay, you got dumb ass writing on your forehead. Cause why are you paying? You married? You paying 50-50? Why do y'all be marrying men that's not providers? Like, I don't. That's literally the whole point. Like, you're supposed to be with somebody that you feel safe, loved, protected, respected, and provided for. Okay. Wow, girl, child, I ain't being with no broke man. Okay, I'm not one to just date people for money. Like, I have to like you as a person, but you cannot be broke. You have to have ambition. You have to have common sense. You have to have good money management, time management. You know, that's a part of just me. For me personally, that's just a part of what I expect in a partner. Like, you have to be a mature human being, financially literate. Like, 3 times, girl. You've been with this man for 12 years, 3 times. Y'all haven't babies too. Like, I get it. Like, he is providing in a way, but that ain't his money. He keep putting y'all in debt, and now y'all can't get y'all mortgage together because you with a man that's make you pay too. That's you. Girl. She says she feel like she don't know what to do. Girl, I want you to get you some brain. I need you to get a brain, just screw it on real good. And I need you to, you gotta do better for you and your kids, because there is no reason you should be going through this situation. Like, even if you are, you're the breadwinner and you make a lot of money, why would you, like, I don't understand how you could just, like, be with somebody and not know that they're doing that shit. Like, you taught him that shit was okay. Your problem started when you started going 50-50 with a man you married with. You're not the asshole, but you are very dumb, and I want you to do better, girl. I want you and them kids to do better. I want you to have your stuff paid off. And good luck to you, girl. Going in debt 3 times. Lying. Girl, the lying is even worse than him being broke. I mean, like, you lied to me once. Oh, I can't do liars. I can't. Anyway, next. We got to move on because I need to get this next, okay? Am I the asshole for telling my sister she does not deserve to be prettier than me? She's my younger sister. I'm 31 and she's 29. She's an overachiever, top of her class, college scholarship, and athlete. The one thing everybody always knew that she was insecure about her appearance. She's the kind of woman who refuses to leave home without a tone of makeup and changes her hair once a week because she never thinks she looks good enough. We look nothing alike. We have different dads. Since our late teens, people assume I'm the younger sister. The fact that I look younger particularly bothers her. I'm a recovered addict, been clean for 4 years, and considering my history, I should probably look worse than I do. My sister lives in Europe now and came home last month for the first time in 4 years. She came to see our whole family at our grandma's house, and was obvious for everyone that she had cosmetic surgeries. Not only does she look way younger, she also used to have more of a round face, and now the shape is totally different. She was always skinny, and now she has curves. May have done something with her eyes and hairline too. She looks great. I even told her that. And the only reason our family knew she had work done is because we knew what she looked like before. She tried to deny and told us it was natural because of her new diet, exercise, and her features just changed as she grew older, but it was all in vain. Everyone could tell there was no way she didn't have any surgeries. Eventually, she gave up and started talking about the surgeries and justify how some of the changes she made weren't achievable any other way, so she had to do it. Our family made fun of her. We tease each other all the time, and a cousin even joked about my addiction problem during a wedding toast. And pointing out the reason why she was distant is because she was probably waiting for the surgeries to heal. I did tease her a bit, congratulated her for finally looking younger than me. She snapped and said, because of my drug addiction, I should look way older, and that she always deserved to look better than me. I talked back, and now things snowballed into a fight where she kept pointing my shortcomings in life and how everything I have is unearned. I told her it's not my fault. She thinks she's better than everyone, and she's not entitled to look a certain way because she has money. We haven't talked since. To my surprise, the family sided with her. They told me I knew how sensitive she was about her appearance and that she did work hard to get what she wanted. Although I was mad because they were teasing her too, I felt guilty because these things are true and she probably had those feelings buried inside for a long time. Am I the asshole? Yeah. You're the asshole. Definitely. Let me just point out, you can change your face with diet, and there's certain non-procedures that you can do to, like, reshape your face, tone your jaw up, all this, lift your eyes. Like, there's ways to do that without getting surgery. You can completely change the way your face looks. Your jaw plays a big part in it. You know, they got gua shaing that works. They have, like, the muscle frequencies that can fix your face. So, I mean, it's not impossible that she did do that. But if she told y'all about the other surgery she had, maybe, I think they said she was always skinny, but her body or whatever. So what? She's happy with the way she looks. The fact that y'all immediately started teasing her about getting work done and, you know, trying to better her appearance or whatever. I mean, all y'all are assholes and y'all haters, but yeah, it was, I mean, she shouldn't have brought up your addiction. Or, I mean, I guess they said they were joking about it. And that they said the reason she was distanced because she was waiting for the surgeries to heal. Well, hold on. Because she said that she congratulated her for finally looking younger than me. And that's when the sister brought up the addiction part. So, yeah, you're the asshole because why would you say that? Like, that was some hater ass shit to say. Congrats on finally looking younger. Like, that's so messed up. Especially if you know that that's somebody's, like, trigger. Like, you know that they're insecure about their appearance. And now that they're finally happy and they did something about it, to say that, it's a very asshole thing to do. I don't think it had anything to do with her having money, that she thinks that she's better than you. No tea, no shade, but she has all these accomplishments and obviously enough money to get surgery and lives in Europe. And congrats on being clean, though. But if she has all these other things that she's proud of, the shell that you occupy, it's important for you to love that as well, because you have to see that every day. And I know that she's probably been holding that, you know, feeling insecure for a long time. So me personally, I have a mouth on me and I try not to use it. I'm a very nice person. Don't say what I be thinking a lot. But I would have said some crazy shit if you was trying to talk about something. Well, congrats on finally looking younger, girl. That was rude. I would have fried your ass up. I would have called you all types of crackheads. Probably would have threw some rice on the floor and told you to go fetch. But I'm sorry. That's, girl, I'm so happy for your sister though. I'm glad she a baddie. I'm glad your family sided with her because you were wrong. They was wrong too for joking about her having surgery. But yeah, girl, I would have fried your ass all the way up. Like, I would have sent you. I would have crucified your ass. Cause you, I'm always pro surgery. If you want to get surgery, you should get it. I'm all for people looking like how they want to look. Cause you only get one body. As long as you do your research, as long as you're sure about what you want to do and it makes you happy. I'm all for it. I will never shame nobody for getting surgery. If your surgery look bad, I mean, get it fixed. But I'm never one of them people that hate on people that get surgery or think that, oh, just because I work out, like I don't work out, but I'm just saying, no, just because I'm natural that I'm better than somebody who has work done. I don't think that at all. Because some of them girls that got their work done, they look better than you because you built like a refrigerator and you still a hater and you ugly. So like I said, hating hoes ain't happy and happy hoes ain't hating. So you up here trying to compete with somebody that had enough money to do what you wish you could do. You spend all that time and energy. And another thing, I probably already said this in that last video, but people be like, oh, I can't stand when celebrities start selling workout plans. Bitch, do you think that just because somebody gets surgery that they don't have to work out? They have to do exercises to maintain the body that they have, because do you know what a BBL is? It's a fat transfer. So that fat is not, it can't just sit there. You still have to do things to make the muscle be able to sit correctly to maintain the fat that that's there. So somebody is selling you something that they use to help maintain their body that they got done. That does not mean that they're lying. Nobody ever, like, I've never seen these celebrities like Ari and them and the celebrity girls that got the influencers that got worked in, I've never seen none of them say, oh, I got this by working out. Like, nobody said that. Y'all just assume that and y'all just want a reason to talk about somebody's BBL or whatever. You still gotta work out with your BBL. And like I said, I've said this somewhere, but y'all act like they making up new exercises. If somebody who's natural, like 100% natural, will tell you to do the exact same fucking exercises. So why are y'all mad that somebody else is telling y'all to do them exercises? You don't have to buy the course. You can go on YouTube and do the same fucking exercises for free. But people buy it because these influencers have their name on it and they want to support them. But like the logic between being mad about somebody who had work done selling a exercise fitness course and doing fitness is really dumb. Because y'all act like they're inventing new exercises. Bitch, everybody is telling y'all to do the same donkey kicks, lunges, and with them little hip thrust. Grow up, okay? Y'all just want to be haters. You worry about you and your body, okay? Maybe you do the exercises and you can look like you had a BBL too, because that's really, they doing the same shit. People who was natural and people who got work done have to do the same exercises to maintain the same shape, to work the same muscles. Okay? Anyway, that's all I got. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Be Along for the Ride. I'll be on Twitch. I watch bad movies, play video games. If you into that, get in there. I will see y'all soon. I appreciate y'all. And let me know what y'all want to see. Oh, excuse me. Let me know what y'all want to see in the comments. All right. Bye.